Okay, people, today we're celebrating, if I can have your attention, we're celebrating two birthdays. We're celebrating Diane Koo, that's turning 100, that did turn 100. And then we're celebrating Marlene, who just turned 39. You said you told me you were 39. I'm just going to go with it. I know, I'm not going to call you a liar. Not to your face, anyway. She knows I love her. So we're going to sing happy birthday, and we're just going to say to you, we're not going to use a name. Well, let's do Diane. We're going to do it twice. What the heck?
Yeah.
We'll do it first.
Why not?
Diane,
why not?
And then we'll do it for Marlene. So here we go. Start singing.
One, two, three.
Happy birthday to you.
The first song we're going to play is called St. Thomas. It was written by saxophonist Sonny Rollins and recorded in 1956. It's a combination of Bohemian and English folk songs that inspired him to write this.
You're going to have to talk louder.
All right, please enjoy.
Can you talk louder?
Yes. Maybe I won't use the mic.
Well, I'm trying to get this together for you. Oh, here we go.
you very much. Did you hear me? That was called St. Thomas.
St. Thomas.
St. Thomas. And now it's time for a song called Now's the Time. This one was written by Charlie Parker in 1945. And he played it with his band, the Reboppers. And that group included Miles Davis, Dizzy Gillespie, Max Roach on drums, and a few others in and out. So here we go with Now's the Time. Next up is a tune from 1941-42. May have been written by this gentleman's clarinet player named Barney Bigger, but Duke Ellington takes credit for it. It was featured in a little film that he did where he was playing with his bass player, I think it was. He was at the piano, and then different members of his band filter in throughout this 15-minute film. But anyway, it's entitled Sea Jam Blues. Duke Ellington.
Thank you. very much. Glad you enjoyed that one. This next song is going to feature Miss Kitty singing a song from a 1936 film that was written by someone who I didn't know was so talented. He wrote the movie, produced the movie, directed the movie, wrote the musical score for the movie, and then told everybody how to act. Charles Chaplin wrote this song for his film Modern Times. Charlie Chaplin.
Wow.
So it was never intended to be, you know, to have lyrics. Those were added by John Turner and Jeffrey Parsons in 1954. So this is Smile by Charles Chaplin.
Oh, the wet tea, maybe ever.
see you all got the cake. How is it? Cake is good? Good. Sure, looks good. Yeah, you don't want to eat cake and then play the horn. That becomes very ugly. So the next tune is from 1958, and its author is disputed. There are two gentlemen, both from Argentina, that are given credit for this song. One is Hugo Blanco, and the other Manzo Peroni. In 1961, it was released in Argentina and Japan. And surprisingly, the Japanese really embraced this song. They loved it, and many Japanese artists recorded this one. This is entitled Coffee Roomba. A little coffee Roomba with your cake? I'm sorry, Coffee Roomba. Thank you. Step is a song from 1939. It was written for the film The Wizard of Oz. It was sung by Judy Garland for about 30 years. That was her signature piece. Won an Academy Award for the best original song. The lyrics are by Yip Harbor, and the song itself, music was composed by Harold Arlen. This is a song you might recognize, Over the Rainbow. Instrumental version. The next song we're going to play is another instrumental from 1944. This was recorded by Johnny Mercer and the Pied Pipers back then. It made it up to number 2 on Billboard's chart, bestseller chart, and lasted about 3 months there. This was written by Alex Kramer, and the title is Candy. Might go well with your cake.
Candy.
Our cake.
Thank you. Glad you enjoyed that. We are going to feature Kitty again. She's going to be singing a song from 1939. This was an instrumental originally based on a 1935 piece that Glenn Miller wrote. And but it turned into a real song in 1939. The lyrics were written in 1965, I think. And Frank Sinatra at that time recorded it. Actually, he recorded this song a few times. Composed by Glenn Miller, this is the lovely Moonlight Serenade.
My darling, a moonlight serenade. to you tenderly. In the June night I spent at your feet, and I see you were so in the moonlight, a love song, my darling.
Lovely Kitty, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, everyone. Next up is a tune that was featured in a 1941 Broadway musical titled Mexican Hayride. I've never heard of it, but the music is great. So this was introduced in 1941 and popularized by a singer by the name of Anita O'Day. Again, I'm not real familiar with her. She's got a lovely voice, though. So this song was written by Wayne King, Victor Young, and Egbert Van Alstyne. And it's entitled Beautiful Love. Thank you. Next song is from 1946, was first released in January 1948. In 1950, Patti Page had a very big hit with this song. It was a multi-million seller. In 1965, the state of Tennessee adopted this song as their fourth official state song. 1998, it was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame, and it spent 30 weeks on Billboard at number one. This was written by Pee Wee King, and the lyrics were written by Red Stewart. This is Tennessee Waltz.
No lyrics today, though. Instrumental. But sing along. If you know the words, please sing it. Richard Burton and Elizabeth Taylor, one of their many films together. It was a minor hit for Tony Bennett for a while. It won a Grammy. It was Song of the Year, won an Academy Award for Best Original Song, just a real popular tune. So I'm gonna do the instrumental version today. This was written by Johnny Mandel, titled The Shadow of Your Smile. Thank you.
Again, you can sing if you like. Original song. Didn't do very well with the public, though. Most people didn't take to it until about 1945. It was composed by Lehi Harline. Not very familiar with him. Maybe he was kind of a movie music composer. But it's a very famous song and very popular. We love it. This is When You Wish Upon a Star. And again, sing if you like to, if you know the words to this. Kitty again, singing a song from 1931. And I'm sorry, I don't have many notes on this. I don't have any notes on this. But it's a great tune. I promise I'll have something next time. This is Dream, a Little Dream of Me. This is a song that's referred to as Gypsy Jazz. It was written by a couple of French gentlemen, one named Django Reinhardt, a guitar player, and his buddy Stefan Grappelli, who played the violin. This became their signature piece that they played all the time, and this is entitled Minor Swing. And thank you for being here today.
Say it again, the title.
Minor Swing. Thank you. You've been a wonderful audience. Have a great afternoon, the rest of us. Thank you.